गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग डिस्कस अबाउट सो स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन डिफरेंट मीडिया. सो द लाइट इज ट्रैवल थ्रू द डिफरेंट मीडिया, इट इज वाटर एंड ग्लास. सो इट्स स्पीड इज सम वॉट रेड्यूस. सो लाइट ट्रैवल्स विद लेसर स्पीड इन एनी मीडियम दैन इट्स स्पीड इन वैक्यूम, दैट इज 3×10⁸ मीटर पर सेकेंड. सो लाइट ट्रैवल्स इन लेसर स्पीड इन द मीडियम कंसिडर एज वाटर एंड ग्लास एंड कंपेयर टू द लाइट ट्रैवल्स इन ग्रेटर स्पीड इन वैक्यूम. It is absence of air. So the speed of light in vacuum and air is almost same. So it's not same. So it's almost same. Then refractive index. So the refractive index of a transparent medium is a ratio of speed of light in vacuum to the speed of light in that medium. So that is speed of light in vacuum is c. Then speed of light in that medium is b. So that is n is equal to c by v. So here speed, here also speed. So meter per second cancel. So there is no unit for refractive index. So the refractive index gives an idea about the speed of light in that medium. So the refractive index of a transparent medium, its a value gives the idea about speed of light in that medium. So how much speed the light travels in that medium. So we see an example. So example 6.5. So the refractive index of a glass, that is 1.5. Then what is the speed of light in that medium? So we know the formula n is equal to c by v. Then just rearrange v is equal to c by n. So substitute the value c is equal to 3×10⁸. Then the refractive index 1.5. So we can do like that. Multiply and divided by 10. So 3×10 30. 1.5×10 15. So 1 15s are 15. 2 15s are 30. So 2×10⁸. Meter second power minus 1. So just see, speed of light in vacuum is 3×10⁸, but if it is in a medium, so speed of light in that medium is 2×10⁸. So it's some values, it's move in lesser speed. So from this example we can understand more clear. Then so the refractive index value is 1 for vacuum. For any other medium it's greater than 1. So whatever the medium, if it is a glass or water, the refractive index value is greater than 1. So higher the refractive index, then greater the optical density. So the density, so density equal to mass by volume. Here the optical density, here so it's a transparent medium, so it's more dense. So higher the refractive index of a medium, greater the optical density, speed of light is lesser and vice versa. So here, so refractive index, so refractive index is more, then optical density is more, then speed of light in that medium is lesser, because refractive index is inversely proportional to speed of light in that medium. So refractive index is more means velocity of light in that medium is less. So if it is less, here velocity of light is more. So it's somewhat, there is a relation. Then just they have given some values. So if it is for vacuum, that is 1. Then if it is for air, it's 1.003. So I have told, so speed of light in vacuum and air is almost same. So speed of light, it's related with the refractive index. So refractive index of air, that is 1.003. So refractive index of vacuum is 1.00, that is 1. Then if it is for carbon dioxide, 1.0005. Then if it is for water, so if it is ice, is 1.31. If it is for water, 1.33. So many values they have given. Just I choose somewhat important. Then glass, it's 1.52. So we will do an experiment in spectrometer using a prism. So the refractive index value is around 1.5. So it's 1.52. Then for diamond, it's 2.42. Then the maximum value, the refractive index maximum value for gallium phosphide, it's 3.50. So they may ask in 1 marks, so what is the refractive index value for gallium phosphide and also diamond, it's 2.42, gallium phosphide 3.50. So in this class we have discussed, so refractive index, don't problem, then speed of light in different medium. So okay, so